Welcome to all. This is e-learning lecture 8. This lecture is in continuation with the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we have learned the type of ropes, their constructions, their designations, and the load acting in the rope. Now, in this lecture, we will learn the design procedure of the wire and we will design a rope with the help of an example. So the basic procedure for designing a wire rope is, first of all, a suitable type of rope is selected for a particular application with the help of table 7.3, 7.4, 7.5 and 7.6. These tables are shown to you in previous lectures. After that, the design load is calculated by assuming a factor of safety 2 to 2.5 times the factor of safety which is given in table 7.8. Then the diameter of wire rope will be calculated by equating its tensile strength to the design load. Diameter of wire and area of rope will be calculated with the expressions which is given in table 7.7. After that, the various stresses in the rope will be defined, and the effective stresses during normal working, during starting and during acceleration of the load will be calculated. Now the factor of safety will be calculated and compared with the factor of safety which is given in table 7.8. If the factor of safety is within permissible limit, then the design is safe. Now let us see an example. It is given that a wire rope for a vertical mine hoist to lift a load of 55 kN from a depth of 300 meters. A rope speed of 500 meters is to be attained in 10 seconds. So what is given to us? The weight lifted is 55 kN. So the depth is 300 meter and the velocity is 500 meter per minute. T is 10 seconds. So the procedure, we will follow the procedure which is shown to you in previous slide. So first of all, we will select a wire for this mine hoist. So the properties of the wire rope for haulage purpose in mines are given in table 7.3. So you can see this is the table for steel wire rope for haulage purpose in mines. So in this table, two types of rope is given, 6 into 7 and 6 into 19. We will select 6 into 19 to be in safer region. So 6 into 19, the average weight is 0.0363 d² is Newton per meter. It is the weight per meter length of the rope, and these are the tensile strength for two types of wires. This is for 1600 megapascal. This is for 1800 megapascal. Now we will select a higher strength of wire of 1800 megapascal, whose tensile strength is 595 d². This tensile strength is in Newton. So we have selected a wire rope of 6 into 19. Now we will select the factor of safety from table 7.8. So table 7.8, the factor of safety for mine hoist is given 876, depending upon the depth. So our depth is 300. So for 300, the factor of safety is 7. So we will multiply this factor of safety 2 to 2.5 times. If we multiply it by 2, we will get 14. If we multiply it by 2.5, we will get 17.5. So we will take a value in between, which is 15. This is the factor of safety we have chosen. So the design load will be calculated by multiplying this 15 to the weight to be lifted, which is 55 kN. Now our design load is 825 kilonewton. After that, we will calculate the rope diameter, which is given in table 7.3. The tensile strength of this wire is 595 d square. So we will equate this tensile strength to the design load. So we will equate this, and the value of the rope dia is 37.2. We will take the integer value 38, and we should check this value with the table 7.3. So here 38, the value after 37.2 is 38. So the rope dia 38 will be chosen. Now we will calculate the wire diameter and the area of rope. The expressions of these are given in table 7.7. So for 6 into 9 wire rope, the wire diameter is 0.063 d, and the area of wire rope is 0.38 d square. So from these expressions, the wire diameter and the area of rope is calculated. The wire diameter comes out to be 2.4 mm, and the area of rope is 550 mm². Now the weight of rope will be calculated. Weight of rope will be, the expression of weight of rope is given in table 7.3, which I have shown you previously. So this is the table, or here is the weight. It is Newton per meter. So this is the rope dia, which is 38. So we will put the value of the rope dia in this expression, and we will get the weight per meter length of wire rope is 52.4. Now the weight is to be lifted from the depth of 300 meter. So the part of rope which is in action is 300 meter. So this will be multiplied by 300, and we will get the value of the weight of rope, which is calculated here, which is 15,720 newton. Now we will calculate the shift diameter from table 7.9. In this table 7.9, for different type of rope, this is the minimum shift diameter, this is preferred shift diameter. So our rope is 6 into 19. These are the preferred shift diameters, and we have to use this rope for mine hoists. So this is the preferred shift diameter, 100 times d. So d is the rope dia, and we will put the value of d in that expression and in this expression, and we will get the value of the shift diameter, which is 3800 mm. Now we will calculate bending stress with this expression. Here ER is 84 gigapascal for steel wire, and we know the value of dW and capital D. We'll put the value of all these parameters into this expression, and the value of sigma b is 53 newton per mm². Now the equivalent bending load on the rope will be calculated by multiplying this bending stress through the net cross section area of the rope, which is 550 mm². So the equivalent bending load comes out to be this value. Now the acceleration of the load on the rope is to be calculated with this, with the help of this expression. And here the value of V is 500 meter per minute, and T is 10 seconds. So the value of A comes out to be 0.83 meter per second square. Now the additional load due to acceleration will be capital W plus small w divided by G into A. We have the value of A, and we have the value of capital W and a small w, we will put these values into this expression, and the load due to acceleration is 5983 newton. Now we will calculate the load due to impact load during starting. Since there is no slack, so the impact load will be 2 times capital W and small w. So impact load will be this value. Now we will calculate the effective load in three conditions: normal working, starting and acceleration. So during normal working, the effective load is capital W plus small w plus bending load, which is we will sum of all these, we will do the sum of all these values, and the effective load during normal working condition is calculated, and the actual factor of safety for normal working condition will be determined by dividing the design load with this load. So it comes out to be 8.26. Now the effective load on the rope during starting will be calculated, which is the impact load plus bending load. And factor of safety will be calculated by dividing the design load with this effective load during on the rope during starting, which is 4.836. Then effective load on the rope during acceleration will be calculated, which is sum of capital W, small w, bending load and load due to acceleration. So we will do sum of all these values and we will get the effective load during acceleration of the load. Then we will calculate the actual factor of safety during acceleration of load. So we will again divide the design load with this value and we will get 7.8 actual factor of safety. Now the factor of safety we have got are in the permissible limit, so the design is safe. So therefore a wire rope of diameter 68 and 6 into 19 type is satisfactory. In case the actual factor of safety calculated is not in the permissible limit, if it is less than the permissible limit, then we will increase the number of wire rope. So After that, our design will be satisfactory. That's all for this lecture. Thank you for watching this lecture.